time to get after it. Y'all ready for a little alcohol funny car action? Ah, you can do better than that. Hey, Summit Motorsports Park, you ready for some alcohol funny cars? Yeah, that's better. I thought so. All right, boys and girls, you've waited long enough. Yeah, we're going to rock you. Waiting to get the official okie-dokie from our safety crew and our starters down there that we are safe and secure and ready to send our first pair of Todd Robertson and Tony Bartone. Gentlemen, we're sitting locked in the cars, loaded. We fired the engines once last night. A little mist came along. We got ready to fire them up again, and then it got a little bit heavier. And now we're sitting here waiting for, again patiently, for Todd Robertson, our reigning division champ, the Eaton and Aeroquip, Monte Carlo bodied entry, Tony Bartone, T-Bone, out of Long Island City, New York, Steve Boggs, his longtime friend, crew chief, getting ready to fire up his machine as well. Soon as, like I said, we get the official okay to send him down the racetrack. Have to have a safe track. Our alcohol funny dragsters made a lap last night. They have a qualifying session in the books. We got one funny car down track last night. That was Bob Thomas. Thomas at the wheel of the Thomas and Muldowney Avenger. Off the line, got down just about the 1,000-foot mark. Car shuffled around a little bit, got up against the wall, scraped the right-hand side of the car, the right header assembly, and, well, that kind of put us on hold for a moment. And by the time we got that issue cleaned up, ready to fire Todd and Tony and send them down the racetrack. It became a situation of we were on hold for Mother Nature. And once again, Mother Nature kind of wagging her little fickle finger of fate at us as we sit and wait patiently for them to give us the all clear down on the starting line that we are ready to go. See, thumbs up. Cyrus, our starter, down on the starting line. The crew guys, Dennis and the rest of the gang over on Todd Robertson's machine. Headphones on. Getting ready to spin the starter on the blower snout. And here we go. Top alcohol funny car qualifying. Getting ready to commence. There is unbelievable Tony Bartone over here on the right-hand side, runner out of Long Island City. T-Bone campaigned in Nostalgia Top Fuel, alcohol funny car, nitro funny car. The man enjoys going fast. His collection of street hot rods, pretty impressive as well. But right now, he's got the Bartone brothers. Chevy Camaro out of New York City. Asphalt and paving contract. here on the right-hand side, looking to put this car into the show. And it's going to be a tough show to get into. We will qualify the quick gate. We've got 14 cars on the ground. That means six of them not going to be able to make the show. Obviously, the weather, certainly a consideration. You have an opportunity to get down the racetrack. You want to take full advantage of it. You want to get in. You want to be able to get into the eight-car show for Sunday. When it's all said and done, you're not in, you can't play. RPM's up, here we go. .567, 269 miles an hour. Tony Bartone rocking the Budweiser side of the racetrack. 5.470. Bartone, one of the quickest cars in the country this year. He's already laid down a 5.44, but that was down in Charlotte a little bit earlier this year. And the atmospheric conditions there, probably just a touch better. But 5.47, 269 miles an hour, great way to open up our alcohol funny car qualifying. Our reigning division champ, Todd Robertson, a nice 5.79 at 2.49. The only thing about that run by Todd Robertson, he had the best seat in the house to watch T-Bone. Tony Bartone go 5.47.0. The gauntlet has been thrown. We've got a racetrack. We've got good air. Chris Foster and Ray Drew do their burnout. Foster out of Davenport, Iowa, coming over from the Quad Cities. There on the left-hand side, the Mustang-bodied machine. Past two-time division champ, past U.S. Nationals winner. Won it all back in 2012 at the Big Go at Indy. For DragRaceHose.com and Goodrich, the Mustang, Foster, looking to put down a number and put himself in the show. Ray Drew finished number two in the division last year. We just saw the reigning champ go down track to a 5.79. Ray Drew and the gang out of Hales Corners, Wisconsin, the K&W Manufacturing Mustang bodied machine, Allen Johnson combination, powering this hot rod down track. Ray Drew and the gang just looking to put a good number down. Now, do you feel confident pulling up to the beams? Sure you do. You just saw Tony Bartone lay down a 5.47 lap. That tells you if you got horsepower, you need to be able to put it to the ground. If you've got horsepower, it's all about being able to go quick, go fast, and make the show. So Foster left side, Ray Drew right side. Two good top five division cars, last year, out of the game. Drew on and off the throttle. Pedals it once, gets out of it. Chris Foster, meanwhile, hangs with it. 5.63, 257 miles an hour for Drew. Rattling the tires a little bit by the 60-foot timer. Just past the Christmas tree. He was already in and out of the throttle. Getting back on, the car going into some shake one more time. Ray's like, you know what, boys and girls? I'm not going to tear this car apart. I'm not going to sling it into a wall. I'm going to keep it safe and secure. The K&W manufacturing machine will be back a little bit later on for qualifying session number two. Tony Bartone, your number one qualifier, 5.47 and 2.69. Understand that those are both ends of the track record here at Summit Racing Equipment Motorsports Park. So T-Bone's one, Chris Foster's two. That 5.63 lap certainly shuffled him in. Rob Feister and Phil Burkhardt Jr. Phil at the wheel of the Permatex. Follow the dream entry, the Chevrolet Camaro. Todd Vaney at the wheel of the car for the last couple of years, picking up numerous wins on the division trail. Burkhardt sliding in to take over driving duties this year is Todd Boehning. Has changed a career path and moved on. Jay Blake, the owner of the Permatex team, a racer that has become blind by accident and is still out and very much involved with this car. You can see him standing right behind the Summit Budweiser guard walls down there, listening in to everything that goes on. Phil Burkhart taking over the driving duties, handpicked to slide into the cockpit. And Burkhart, Virginia Motorsports Park a little bit earlier this year, already taking the Permatex machine to the final round. Rob Feister out of Kentucky, the Video Solutions Champion Chevrolet machine over there on the left-hand side. Chevrolet Camaro bodied entry. The guys race out of their own pocket. No sponsorship. They call it the tight budget machine. And let me tell you, alcohol buddy car racing ain't cheap. Burkhart, nice lap down the racetrack, 5:57, 2:63. Jay Blake will be smiling, likes that number. That'll put him up in the number two spot for now. 6:44 by Feister, the champion Chevrolet entry. 6:44, only 1:66. You can see him off the throttle, but 263 miles an hour by Burkhart, the Permatex car. Nice, straight and true down the Budweiser side of the racetrack. T-Bone 1, Burkhart 2, Chris Foster 3, Todd Robertson, your quick 4 so far. All of them 5.79 are better. But you know what? Don't go away. Here comes the past champ. Number 5 in the world last year, Steve Harker. The transplanted Australian, now living in Gainesville, Florida. Coming up in his Chevrolet Camaro machine and out of Whiteford, Maryland. Number 5 in Division 1 competition last year, DJ Cox. DJ, already a winner this year. Remember that race I was telling you about in Virginia Motorsports Park where Phil Burkhart and the Permatex team were runner-up? Well, this Monte Carlo coming up on the Budweiser side of the racetrack. This is the car they were runner-up to. So DJ, Chuck, and the rest of the gang out of Maryland know how to make their way through some tough competition. Make their way to the final round of eliminations. Make their way to the winning circle. There's DJ, the East Coast Auto Electric entering machine. And Steve Harker finished number 2 in 2008. A couple of times he finished number 2. Took home the championship a couple of years ago. Finished number 5 in a hotly contested battle in 2015. Harker, like we said, the transplanted Australian. Now living here in the States. Bear up on the left-hand side. So that 5:47 you saw earlier by Tony Bartone, I gotta tell you, it may be in trouble. Steve Harker's Camaro is quick and fast. DJ's Monte Carlo here on the right-hand side. For East Coast Auto Electric and Dixie Construction, it's quick, it's fast. Both of these cars certainly know what needs to be done to get down the quarter mile. Harker left side, DJ Cox right, top 5 in the country left lane, top 5 in the division right side, RPMs up, away we go. DJ out of the gate, gets up close to the right hand wall. Steve Harker shuffles around a little bit, 598, 184 by DJ Cox. Steve Harker 655 at 154, and down at the other end of the racetrack, Tony Bartone, Steve Boggs go, dodged one bullet. So Tony still 5:47.0, the new track record for alcohol funny car. 2:69.35, the new speed record for alcohol funny car. But we're not done. We got more guys to go, and you know what? We actually have some racing to do. As coming up next will be our semifinals from Indianapolis. We worked our way through the first round of elimination at Indy, got ourselves down to the final four. Johnny Lindbergh and Paul Noakes scheduled to run each other. Scotty McVeigh and Tony Bogalo scheduled to run each other. And we're going to run those rounds as we run qualifying. So not only will these rounds count for qualifying for the event here this weekend at Summit Motorsports Park, they're also going to count towards eliminations and a chance of taking home the Wally from our Moistured Out event in Indy back on the 1st. So Noakes in the left lane, Johnny Lindbergh over on the right-hand side. Johnny Lindbergh now lists Brownsburg, Indiana home. He's from Sweden. But he has moved down to the country where he can race his alcohol funny car on a much more consistent basis than he can back home. Lindbergh carries the number one on the side of the car, the world championship team. One of the quickest funny cars in the country, 536. The record, 274 miles an hour, the record. And Lindbergh's machine, certainly capable. He likes the cool conditions they're used to tuning for and running under these types of conditions, believe it or not, in Sweden. They were in the 550s. Racing in Indy. Paul Noakes and the gang were in the 570s and 560s racing at Indy. The Meritor Mustang for the guys out of London, Ontario, Canada. A international battle, if you will, as we have Canada taking on Sweden here in the United States here at Summit Motorsports Park. Runner here goes to the final round of our Indy event. Both drivers looking to get into the show. Right now it takes an 8:46 to make the field. Right now, a very important run. Oh, out of the gate first, Paul Noakes, Johnny Lindbergh on and off the throttle, and an upset in the semifinals. 5:62 by Noakes. 257 miles an hour. Lindbergh off the line, drove into some tire shake, tried to settle it back down, got her out there about the half track mark, got back into it. You could see the car start tossing from side to side one more time. Johnny's like, well, there goes Paul. I might just well save it for later. 791, 116 if you're in the pits. Paul Noakes moves on. He's in the show, and he's in the final round for our race at Indy. We will finish that up a little bit later on today, but a fine 562 lap, 257 miles an hour. So Noakes is in. Lindbergh is not. The bump is Steve Harker's 655 now. At the other end of the quarter mile, you should see that number up on the scoreboards. Tony Bogalo and Scotty McVeigh getting ready to come up next as we get the all clear from the other end of the racetrack. Tony Bogalo and Scotty McVeigh qualifying for the race here this weekend. but also running for a chance now to run Paul Noakes in the finals of our Indy event. Tony on the left side. Tony able to get around Ray Drew in the opening round at Indy. Laying down a 5.71. Scott McVay was in the 5.60s for the majority of the weekend. He's able to get down and pass Chris Foster in the opening round at Indy. So here we are, semifinal confrontation. Two things on hand. One, you want to get into the show. Two, you want to win, because this is a round of elimination. Now, we just saw Paul Noakes take out the number one qualifier at Indy, Johnny Lindbergh. When it comes to racing, you need to be able to run your race in your lane on your day, and you can't worry about who's in the other side. Tony Bogalow, left lane. Victory Vows machine. Ohio-based runner. Scott McVay out of Ile de Chien, Manitoba, Canada. Over here on the right-hand side, Will Hanna. Coming up from Texas to lend a little tuning credence to the car this weekend. They had it running pretty good in Indy. Let's see if they can keep it running pretty good here in Norwalk. RPMs will come up. Both cars in. Here we go. Tony Bogalow jumping the gun, driving the top in, and gets absolutely nothing for it. He left before the tree is activated. Scott McVay goes to the finals, 8:46 at 115 miles an hour. And like I said, you have to run your race in your lane and cannot worry about what happens on the other side. And for Scott McVay, for Paul Noakes, couple of good runs that weren't necessarily record-setting, but they were good enough to get him into the final round. Scott McVay goes 8:46. He'll give up lane choice to that 5:62 lap from Paul Noakes. And our finals are set for Indy competition. Noakes and McVay into the finals of the Alcohol Funny Car Competition.